How's it going, YouTube? I'm coming at you with a very, very important video today. I'm going to walk you through how to check the clipping point of your head unit, whether it's an OEM head unit or an aftermarket one. The process is very similar, and it's very important that you do this right so that you can protect your investment and you don't blow your gear. Stay tuned on how to get loud. All right, guys, so this is how I have it wired up and set here to go ahead and show you how to check the clipping point of your head unit. And I wanted to do it on the bench here just to make it easier, more space to move around and to actually show you how I got everything wired here so that you can go ahead and test your system to see when your head unit clips, which is very, very important to know. Gosh, there may be one or two out of thousands and thousands of head units where you can turn the volume all the way up and it won't clip. Nine times out of 10, your head unit, your aftermarket head unit, your factory head unit, it's going to clip and send a clip signal before you reach your max volume. So it's very, very important, whether you're using an OEM stereo or an aftermarket one, that you do this so that you know what volume level never to go past, okay? Because you never want to send a clip signal to your system, okay? Especially if you're running an amplified setup, and you know, you're running some big power, you just don't want to do that. All right, guys, so for this test here, I am using a flat setting. So bass is zero, we got treble zero, all that is level, loudness off. So I recommend that if you're going to adjust any of those, you do that now, and then you do the test to see what your clipping point is, because it's going to be different, okay? It's going to be different if you do different settings. But to get a true clipping point of your head unit, then set everything flat, and that'll tell you at a flat point where your max volume is before you clip. Okay, this head unit goes all the way up to 40. Okay, typically it's around 75 to 85%, so I'm guessing clipping point will be somewhere between I'd say 33 to 37, generally speaking. So let's go ahead and connect this up and see what we got here. All right, so really quick, how I have everything wired. I have my 12-volt battery over here connected with a voltmeter so I can monitor its charge, make sure it's fully charged. I do have a battery charger to keep it charged up. And then I also have my head unit here. So the head unit is connected, obviously positive, negative to the battery. And I got two speakers, my front left and front right. As you can see, my front left here connected to the white speaker outputs. And then my front right speaker connected to the gray speaker outputs. And that's it. I'm not using the rear speakers or anything else. So I wanted to make it simple so that you can follow along real easy, not to complicate things, okay? Over here, I have my tablet that's connected to my head unit here via Bluetooth. And I have a 40 hertz test tone here that I'm going to be playing. Now, as far as what frequency to play, yes, you can play 1,000 hertz. That's typically what people do. However, I wanted to do a 40 hertz test tone, and there's a couple reasons why, because if you do that, you can actually hear distortion a lot better, and I'm gonna show you that and prove to you that you can actually hear distortion by ear at the actual clipping point based off the O-scope, okay? That's why tuning by ear is very, very simple if you know what to listen for, and I'm gonna show you what to listen for and prove it with the O-scope that you can hear when clipping happens and when your speakers start to distort. And finally, over here, I have my trusty $40 O-scope, okay? And I have it connected to one of my speakers here. Again, you just need to connect it to one. You don't need to test your front door, your back door, your right rear door. All you gotta do to check the clipping point of your head unit is just connect it to one of your speakers, okay? Now, it's important to note that the speaker that you're testing, it cannot be amplified. So if you have a separate amplifier going to the speaker, it's not gonna work. You gotta test your clipping point of your amplifier. In order to test the clipping point of your head unit, you need to check at a point of non-amplification from anything but your head unit, okay? So what you can do is I could connect the leads to here where they're actually coming out of the head unit, or for people that already have their head unit installed and it's easier for them to pull a speaker out of their door, that's totally fine. You know, just imagine this is your door here. You pull the speaker out and you go ahead and connect your positive and negative to it, right? You can leave everything connected just to make it easy. Just connect the positive and negative of your oscilloscope here to your speaker with everything connected, and you'll be good to go. Again, as long as these speakers are getting their power from the head unit and not an external amplifier, you can still check the clipping point of your head unit as is, just like this, and you'll be good to go. And finally, as far as settings for this test, I have it obviously powered on. I have it set to AC mode. I have it set to 2 volts and I have it set to 10 milliseconds. Okay. Depending on your output of your head unit, what track you play, the test tone, it's going to be different. But if you're using a similar head unit with a 40 hertz test tone, this is what your setup is going to be to go ahead and see the numbers. All right, so what we're going to do first, with everything muted or paused, we're going to go all the way up and see what our max volume is. So our max volume on this head unit is 40. I always recommend starting about halfway. Okay, so we'll go down to 20. I don't know any head unit that clips at halfway point. So we can go ahead and start at 20 and then go ahead and play the test tone. All right, so I got that 40 hertz test tone loaded. I'm going to go ahead and press play and go ahead and start cranking it up. You can see the speaker starting to move there already. I'm gonna look at the graph here. Put it closer to get there. We're at 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, clip, 36. Let's try that again. Let me go back down to 30. All right, so I'm starting at volume 30. Okay, let's go ahead and look at this oscilloscope here. 32, 33, 34, 35. There's max unclipped volume. And there's clip right there. Look at that signal. Boom. Ooh, that's really bad. Ooh, that's really, really bad. All right, so we determined max unclipped volume is 35. Okay. Still looks good. When I go up to 36, you can see that wave does not look clean. 37, it's even more apparent. Terrible. All right, guys, now I'm gonna have a test here to see who has the hearing to be able to distinguish when these speakers are clipping, okay? You don't need a graph, okay? You definitely don't need expensive equipment like a real oscilloscope or a SMD DD1 or anything like that. You can use your ears to hear when your speakers are distorting. It's not that difficult. And that's why sometimes I like using a lower frequency, because it's easier to hear distortion than it is with like a 1000 hertz test tone. So let's have a little fun here and see if people can hear when the speakers start to distort. Okay, and we know that that volume, what, 36, right? So when we're at 36, everybody should be able to hear when it's distorting. All right, and during this test, I'm not gonna show the oscilloscope. I'm not gonna show the volume here of where it's at. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show the speakers, and I want you to think to yourself, okay, that's when it's distorting. And as soon as it's there, I'm going to come here and prove that it distorted at the volume that you heard. So anyway, let's go ahead and get this going. Now I actually want you to look at the graph and I want you to hear when distortion comes in. You can hear when distortion comes in and actually correlate it with the clip signal. Okay, so let's try that. Well, there you have it, YouTube. Now you know how to check the clipping point of your head unit using either a cheap $40 oscilloscope or simply your ears, as we've proved it's possible. So I hope this video helped add value to the YouTube community, to the car audio enthusiasts out there, to help you take your builds to the next level. Let's get loud.